Knowledge for Men, episode 71.
Welcome to knowledgeformen.com, where you're going to grow into the man you want to be. Your life will never be the same again. I can guarantee it.
This episode is brought to you by my private online men's group called The Lion's Den. You can check it out at knowledgeformen.com and click on The Lion's Den. If you've been listening to this podcast and you like the content, but find it hard to find other guys out there to relate to, talk to, share your wins and challenges with, maybe you're on your own path of personal development and other guys think it's weird or they're just not interested in what you're doing. You kind of feel like you're alone on this mission, but you're not. There's thousands of other guys out there who are on the same path, and I've been putting together a group called The Lion's Den to try and find these guys, bring them together. Hey, I know it's hard to make the push towards greatness in your life, and I found that the best way to get somewhere you've never been is to surround yourself with other people who are already there or who are on the same path as you. So The Lion's Den does just that. It's a group of men who want to achieve greatness in all areas of life: health, wealth, relationships, and personal growth. Check it out at knowledgeformen.com and click on The Lion's Den. What's up, guys? Andrew Ferebee here, and this episode is going to be just me, and the title of this episode is The 21 Things to Let Go to Become the Happiest Person in the World. So on this journey that I've had so far, I've been able to meet a lot of people, a lot of really successful people, and it hasn't always been that you see these people and they're extremely happy. Just because you have financial success does not mean that you're gonna be happy. However, that saying does go that you often hear is that you'd rather be crying in a Ferrari than, you know, an old Honda Civic, whatever that means to you. That's the rebuttal. Well, I wanna just go over some things that I found in on my journey, some things that I've written down and things that I've experienced firsthand after meeting a lot of people in person and via interview and going to dozens of events around the country, put together a list of the 21 things that you gotta let go to become the happiest person in the world. Because at the end of the day, it's really about becoming happy. I mean, everything you do is about becoming happy. If I was to ask you, why do you do what you do? You might say, oh, you know, I want to get this car. I want to get this house. Or it's, oh, I want to improve my dating life so I can have this girl. Or it's, you know, I want to have a better body. You know, I want to lose weight and have more muscle and look good. You know, I want to look good with my shirt off, and what guy doesn't? And if I was to ask you, well, why do you want that? All of those things. If I was to really ask you why? If I just kept asking you why. You know, I've done this dozens of times with my clients that I coach. And at the end of the day, you know, you want that car because you think it's going to make you happy. You want that bigger house because it's going to make you happy. And if you have a lot of, you know, these big parties and, you know, you have that prestige and that respect, then it's going to make you happy. If you have a, you know, this beautiful girlfriend and you're going out and you have this, you know, a good relationship, and, you know, is it about the girl or it's going to make you happy? And having that good body, just being able to walk on the beach and know that you look really good and, you know, you worked hard for it. It's going to make you happy is the thinking. And not to say that any of those things are wrong. I, of course, want to have good things going on in my life, and I want to have financial success. And obviously, I'm building this business and I study entrepreneurship and I go to the gym regularly and I coach guys with dating. And, you know, I've had quite the time with dating lots of women. And I just want to reverse this process of trying to chase these external things. And maybe if we start out with happiness, and instead of chasing the monetary or chasing the girl or this body, I believe that if we are happy internally with who we are as a man and we are happy from within, not from the external, then we can be much happier, and it'll be a much easier process to actually get the things that we want. You see what I'm saying? It's let's become happy first and then go out and crush life and then go out and get the things that you want, knowing that these things won't make you happy, but you're doing it for the challenge. You know, I love entrepreneurship because it is the toughest sport in the world. Because you can, if I was to ask, you know, what's the toughest sport in the world, you can easily say, Oh, it's got to be, you know, football, rugby, and then, you know, I would argue, you know, it's the UFC, it's MMA, because you're fighting, right? You know, you're actually fighting, and there's blood, and your arm could be broken, and your leg can be twisted, and all sorts of things. You can go to the hospital, you know. Well, the toughest sport is actually entrepreneurship, because when you're fighting, you have 3 5-minute rounds. So it's a 15-minute situation that you're getting yourself involved in. And if it's a championship fight, then it's a 5-round fight. So now we're looking at 25 minutes and then you're done. You know that it's going to end. And whether or not you win or lose, you still get your money. So UFC and MMA, it's tough. I understand. I respect the sport. But entrepreneurship is 24/7 and your life is on the line like it's never been before. That is the toughest sport, entrepreneurship. And so I'm a big fan of that. And to get back on track with happiness, what I'm about to share here isn't for everyone. I want you to know that not everyone is ready to experience the truth. So I'm going to give you an opportunity right now. I'm going to give you 2 pills, and it's only for your own safety. I'm going to give you the red pill, and I'm going to give you the blue pill. And so if you take the blue pill, right now the story ends and you go back to your current life. You sink back into the ordinary daily grind and nothing changes. Tomorrow will be just like today, which was like yesterday. So you can go ahead and hit the close button on this, and you don't need to listen to this. This isn't for you. On the other hand, you can take the red pill, and I'll show you how to break free from social constructs and become the happiest person in the world. You'll experience a new life, and you'll be full of unlimited abundance, happiness, and prosperity. If this is you, continue reading, grab some water, take the red pill, because your life will never be the same. So this is the 21 things to let go to become the happiest person in the world. You see, we've been conditioned by ourselves and by society to cling on to things that don't really matter. They're social constructs. When you realize that everything is nothing but perspective, you become free for the first time in your life. It gives you peace, and it removes the burden of having to act according to who you are, quote unquote, and what is left. You'll have sheer happiness vibrating throughout your entire body. You can't control everything that happens in life, but you can choose how you respond. You can learn to see opportunity where others see misfortune. It's all down to your perception of the event. Virtually everything that makes us unhappy is the result of the way we think, the way we cling to, and the way we mislead our lives and ourselves. You see, you have unlimited talent and potential, but it can't break through until you've freed your mind. When you are no longer a prisoner of your mind, you set yourself free to do the things that really matter and start creating some truly amazing shit in your life. Here's a quote from Lao Tzu. He's a philosopher. Be content with what you have. Rejoice in the way things are. When you realize there's nothing lacking, the whole world belongs to you. If you complete this episode and apply its lessons, then your life can become stress-free, hyper-productive, and absolutely amazing if you just let go of these 21 things. I've done it. I've worked for the last year working on this, and I'm happy to share this with you now. So understand that it won't be easy, and changing the way you think is going to take a lot of time. It's going to challenge you. It's going to put you in an uncomfortable situation, and you may not like it. If that happens, keep going. But you have to understand that you can start this today, taking your first steps down the path to greater happiness, personal fulfillment, and unlimited abundance. But I want you to buckle up, strap in, and get ready to experience the truth. Number one, let go of the past. Living in the past isn't living at all. It's time consuming, it's painful, and a little crazy actually. Don't be preoccupied with old errors or things you've lost. All of that's behind you. The past is not a thing. It's an illusion, a concept we all share, and because it helps us make order in the world around us, but it's simply not real. What's past is gone. It's gone forever. It's only in your mind. There is only the present, and that's all you'll ever have. If you live in the now, you'll be full of life. Maybe the present is terrible. Maybe you don't like it. And maybe you had a better life in your past. Maybe you had a perfect girl, a great job, you had more money, and maybe you've lost all of that, and the present actually sucks. So what? You're not going to get back to that level of happiness by wallowing in how bad you feel now. The only thing you can do is take the lessons that you've learned and start taking action in the present to make for a better tomorrow. Here's a quote by George Harrison. It's being here now that's important. There's no past and there's no future. Time is a very misleading thing. All there is ever is the now. We can gain experience from the past, but we can't relive it. And we can hope for the future, but we don't know if there is one. You see, accept the things that have come before as lessons learned and stepping stones towards a brighter future. Have a clear vision for the future. Prepare in the present and live for now. Number two, let go of the job you hate. You will live for, on average, 30,000 days, and 10,000 of those days is spent working. When you actually stop and consider that, it's obvious that working a job that makes you unhappy is completely insane. Why would anyone willingly spend a third of their life being miserable or doing something that you don't want to do? If I was to tell you on your day off that I want you to dig a hole and fill it back up, what would you say? What if I said I was going to pay you the least amount as possible for you to dig a hole and fill it back up? Would you do it? Absolutely not. You wouldn't do it because it's your day off and this is the time that you have to enjoy life. Now I want you to flip that. I want you to reverse that so that you enjoy all of your time and that it's not just this one day that you cherish, but you cherish all of the days and that you're not willing to sacrifice a day to make a measly paycheck. I understand that you have things to do and you have things to pay for and you're probably in debt, but you put yourself in debt. You followed society and society said that you should probably get these things, live this way, and go out and do these things and buy this or that. All you can do is accept where you are now, start working to pay off those debts, and start building something that you really care about with your life. I can't tell you enough that this is really the secret and that if you really start to build something that you're passionate about, it ignites everything within your body and you'll be unstoppable. I've done it with what this podcast is and that's what it is. Find something you love, go for it, 100%. When you're doing that, you don't even care about money. You don't even care about your clothes. You don't even care so much about what you eat. You care about what you're doing. You care about what you're building. You care about your legacy. You care about the way people are going to view you in the future. You know, you want to leave behind artifacts. Artifacts being your legacy, your business, your relationships, your friendships, everything. What will you leave behind? Live for now. Okay, so back to this letting go of the job you hate. You know, why would anyone willingly spend a third of their life being miserable? Here's a quote by one of the richest men in the world and one of the best investors of our time who is still alive. It's by Warren Buffett. He said, building up your resume is like saving up sex for old age. Your life isn't meant to be put on hold. You don't wait for that. You enjoy it while you can because time is limited and you never know when it's your time. So live your life, and when you're living your life and you're truly happy, that's when you're at your best. And that's when you can make the biggest contributions to those around you. It may seem selfish to be trying to chase your passion and do something that you love while others aren't, especially those you love around you. But when you are at your peak performance and you are at your optimal best, this is what's good for those around you because you'll be able to take care of those. You may be making more. You'll be happier. You'll be less frustrated about the little things. You'll be focused on those relationships because you know that they matter. Follow your heart and intuition, and you know your work is going to feel timeless. Find work that inspires you and all the people around you. You want all of it. The work that will generate the velocity to work insane hours, make the most in return, and love what you do all the while. This is your passion. You can dramatically improve your happiness by letting go of the job you hate and start doing more of the things that you love. What's your legacy going to be? Your work is your contribution to society, the mark you make, the thing you leave behind. Hone your skill set until nobody can ignore you. Use your natural drive for doing what you love to fuel your efforts and watch everything fall into place. Here's what Confucius said. Choose a job you love, and you will never have to work a day in your life. Listen, if a guy from thousands of years ago said that when working was way extremely harder back in the day, and it still applies today, there's something to be said about that. And so don't allow your obligations to dictate how all of this plays out. You can keep your day job, I understand, you have bills. And the thing is you still have weekends and nights to work towards breaking into what you really want to do. There's no excuses. You have a few days off, and you do have the time off after work. Yeah, you're tired, but you only live once. What will you remember? Will you remember the times that you watched TV? Or will you remember the time that you were able to give a presentation in front of the people that you love and you were able to share with them how you worked extremely hard on this side business or something that you were passionate about while maintaining a full-time job and you took care of your family and you took care of your relatives and your sick mother? You did all of this and you were able to push through and build a business and a legacy that pays for your children's future. Do you want to say that story? Is this the story that you want to write? Because it's your choice. No one else can stop you. No one else is going to tell you to do it. Well, I guess I am right now.
But very few people are going to stand in front of you and tell you that you should work your ass off and do it while you have a job. And actually, you will suffer a little bit. Actually, I'm not going to say a little bit. You will suffer. It will be really hard and it'll challenge you. But this is what life is about. Understanding that the obstacle is the way, and there's no shortcut to success. There's no elevator that just hit a button and you go straight up. You got to climb the stairs. In fact, you actually have to crawl up the stairs as if it was the Empire State Building, or even better yet, the New World Trade Center, which stands at 1776 feet in the air. Notice the symbolism there, 1776, the year the country was born. Anyways, you don't want to allow your obligations to dictate how all this plays out. You know, you can really keep your day job. Resist the urge to do things solely for money and start doing the things that matter to you. The things that put on a smile on your face that screams out loud, "I am the happiest person in the world." Do what you love. Number 3, let go of your need to always be right. Nobody's right all the time, and in many disagreements, neither party is truly wrong in the first place. There are countless points of view and ways to think about any given situation. When you go find yourself drawn into a heated debate, understand that there is no real way to win. Just let go, seriously. Here's a quote by Friedrich Nietzsche. "You have your way, I have my way. As for the right way, the correct way, and the only way, it does not exist." Conversations too often become competitions, which turn into arguments or fights which can last years. Instead of enjoying a healthy exchange of ideas and understanding someone else's points of view, we sometimes find ourselves trying to prove ourselves, because to prove that we're the smartest, that we're the best, and that we know better, shows that we're worthy. Listening is put on hold while we think of what we're going to say next. Guys, learn to listen, and people will appreciate that you're thoughtful and that you care about what they have to say. People will find you to be the best conversationalist in the world when you seriously just stop saying so much and just start listening and become genuinely interested in what others have to say and understanding their points of view, their background, their childhood. Why do they think this way? What leads them to think this way? What has happened in their past that makes them think this way? Even if you completely disagree, it's better to just understand and connect and understand that this is the way that they are. If you accept someone for who they are as a person, instead of trying to change them into who you think they are or who you want them to be, then that's when you can actually start building some awesome relationships and some deep connections, and you can really go internal instead of having these surface layer relationships that really don't lead to anything and are often forgotten, and they end up just being another friend on Facebook.
All right, I want to give you more details about the Lion's Den. It's a private Facebook group where you post your goals in health, wealth, relationships, and personal growth. The guys hold you accountable, and you have a place where you can get instant feedback from other high-performing men from around the world. You can get more details at knowledgeformen.com and click on the Lion's Den. There's men's coaches in there, there's dating coaches, fitness coaches, millionaires, guys with startups, guys who just graduated college and are happy to be surrounded by so many guys just making it happen for themselves. There's fathers in there, military personnel, and just all walks of life from all over the world. 70 guys strong right now and growing every day. But the one thing that we all have in common is that we just want to achieve greatness. We want to push ourselves. We want to challenge ourselves. We want to really just become the men we want to become and do it not alone. We don't want to do this journey, take this path alone. We want to do it together with other men. And that's what I find so powerful about this group. We also do monthly Google Hangouts, which is sort of like an online meetup with about 12 guys in each Hangout. So you can meet all these guys and build stronger relationships with other high-performing men. And there's also a structure to each Hangout. Guys, this group only costs $19 a month for a limited time. You can get more details and you can set up a consultation with me at knowledgeformen.com and click on the Lion's Den and get started from there.
Number 4, let go of all the negative people in your life. Some people just suck the life right out of you. I know, it hurts. And these can be people around you, or people that you were once friends with, or even people that you used to love, or still do. There are some people out there who help you, and there are some people out there who bring you down. Some people make you a better man, actually. You have control over the people you surround yourself with, and you're not truly obligated to keep anyone in your life, especially the people who drag you down. The people you keep should love you, challenge you, and make you want to be better. Here's a quote by Andrew Bernstein. "Negative thoughts stick around because we believe them, not because we want them or choose them." You see, those who bring negative energy into your life will only make it harder for you to feel happy or to get anything done for that matter, and they won't be helping themselves either. You're not doing them any favors by keeping them around in your life. Simply let them go. There isn't a shortage of incredible people in the world. People who will help you achieve your goals and who will love you and understand you for who you are. These are the people you give your time and energy to, because they're the ones that deserve it. No one else. It's really that plain and simple and that blunt. You have to let go of the people, the negative people, who no longer serve you. I know that's really mean and that's hard to do, but you got to keep that in mind as you move forward. As if you want to be happy, the negative people will always be there bringing you down. Number 5, let go of your need for control over everything. It's true what they say. You're only human. You're not God. In general, expending energy trying to do the impossible is bad for your health. Controlling everything is one of those impossible things, and yet many of us try to do it anyways, often without even realizing it. Understand human limitations. Know that you can't control much in life, but you can always control your reaction. Flow through the world smoothly. When there is resistance, flow around it. When there is opportunity, flow right through it. Here's a quote by my favorite martial artist and one of the most influential men in my life, Bruce Lee. He said, "Empty your mind, be formless, shapeless like water. If you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. Now water can flow or it can crush. Be water, my friend." You see, you can't control the situations around you, your loved ones, strangers, coworkers, the economy, anything for that matter, but you can sure as hell waste your time trying to. Don't fall into that trap. Let things be. Simply just let them be. And handle difficult situations gracefully. Let them flow. When you let go of your need to control everything, you'll feel much happier and you have more time to do the things that truly matter, the things you love, the things that make you happy, and spend time with the people you care about and love. Just simply stop trying to control everything and just let it be. Be water, my friend. Number 6, let go of your need to impress others. People are drawn to the genuine article. We appreciate sincerity, even if we don't realize it, and all of us recognize someone who's really faking it, even if it's, you know, at the instinctive gut level. Lao Tzu said this, "Care about what other people think, and you will always be their prisoner." Let me repeat that again, because this can truly free some of you who are listening. Lao Tzu said, "Care about what other people think, and you will always be their prisoner." Don't try to be something you're not just to make others like you. It won't work. It never has, and it never will. This is a simple truth that, well, you know, popular people know. The moment you drop the mask and embrace the real you, people will flock to you. What makes each of us our most appealing self are the unique traits and experiences we have. They're your greatest assets. Always be you. There's no one else to be but you. This is your life. You were given a unique set of skills, looks, attributes that make up you. Be you. Be happy that you can be you. There's really no other way around it. When you put yourself out there as someone you're not, you cast those assets aside. You simply just threw away all the goods that whatever higher power gave you. You have to be you. Bernard Marich said, "Be who you are and say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind." The harder you work to impress others, the less impressive you'll be. Have confidence in who you are, and fully express yourself openly, and devote yourself to those who appreciate the real you. If you come across people who don't appreciate the real you, people who want you to change who you are, don't sweat it. Do you really need them in your life so badly that you let them dictate who you are as a person? They're basically asking you to throw away the assets that you've been given. They're asking you to hide them under the bed. They're asking you to throw them away and never be seen. No. You're always going to shine your assets because it's who you are. It's what you are and it's the way you are. And there's no other way. The moment you realize this and really accept this, you can really just stop listening to me talk. You can turn off Knowledge for Men because the world is yours. And I can't wait till you do. Nobody should control you. You're better than that. Stop letting the outside world tell you who you are and what you should do. I just left a little moment of silence there because it's that important. Number 7, let go of your resistance to change. Chances are you believe the future can be better than the present, or you're living in the past, but like I said, you gotta let go of the past. You probably have aspirations and desires and goals, as you should. Most of us do. We write our goals down and we're really excited when we do. Yet, paradoxically, many fear change even while we simultaneously want it. Here's a quote by Eckhart Tolle. "Some changes look negative on the surface, but you will soon realize that space is being created in your life for something new to emerge." Remember, we have no control over the things that happen to us and the changes that occur. around us. But we always have control over how we respond. Notice this is a key theme here with letting go and becoming happy. Train yourself to see every change, whether wanted or unwanted, as an opportunity for something greater. You can't see the future, so choose to believe that everything is happening for a reason. Embrace reality and let it be. Change will help you flow from A to B, literally. Here's another quote by Lao Tzu. Life is a series of natural and spontaneous changes. Don't resist them. That only creates sorrow. Let reality be reality. Let things flow naturally forward in whatever way they like. Always be moving forward in a positive direction. Follow your bliss, blaze your own path, and embrace change. Don't resist it. When you let go and embrace change, it becomes your greatest weapon against mediocrity. Number 8, let go of your fears. Fear is just an illusion. You have to understand that. It's not real. Someone show me a picture of fear. It doesn't even exist. You created it. It's in your mind. It's that little voice. Slap that shit. Get him out of there. It's not something you can see and touch. It's nothing you can cure with a pill. No amount of money can keep it at bay. It's a simple reality of human life, and it's all in your head. Everyone feels fear. Winners just don't let it cripple them. They set it aside and just do it. They still experience fear. Someone who's fearless is actually a little bit weird. Courageous people are actually scared, and they do experience fear, yet they just walk through it. It's like walking on fire. It's not going to kill you. It's just going to hurt your feet, and you're scared, but you just keep walking through it. You embrace the fear, and you walk through it. If you imagine fear like a cape, just put the cape on. It's always with you. It never goes away, but it becomes a part of who you are, and it only makes you stronger. It's there. It never goes away. You have to understand this. There's never a day when you're just not going to be fearful if you're about to take a new risk. It will always come. But with experience and practice, you'll learn how to control the fear and use it as an ally. Understand that seriously, life's too short to get hung up on what you're afraid of. You got to move forward. And Jim Morrison said, expose yourself to your deepest fear. After that, fear has no power, and the fear of freedom shrinks and vanishes. You are free. Always remember, I've said this before in this podcast, on the other side of fear is growth. It's the only way. Clear your mind, put things in perspective, and realize that worse than fear itself is not taking action because you're afraid of failure or a bruised ego. Inaction is what keeps lives from becoming great. Inaction is what will rob you of becoming the greatest you. Don't let this happen. Let go of the fears. Let go of all your excuses. How often have you known what you need to do but put it off for some bullshit reason? Your brain tends to want to maintain a comfortable status quo and avoid pain. As such, you naturally create excuses not to do things that your subconscious perceives as uncomfortable or even just risky. Excuses prevent you from doing what you're afraid of, and they keep you safe, at least on the surface level. But we know that excuses are simply limiting your growth. You don't want a complacent, lazy life. If you did, you wouldn't be listening to this. Here's what our man Benjamin Franklin has to say. He that is good for making excuses is seldom good for anything else. If you look at Maslow's hierarchy, it really just wants you to get food, it wants you to have sex, and it wants you just to have some shelter. Once you've accomplished those things, your body kind of shuts down, and it doesn't really need to fight anymore. If you want to achieve higher levels of success in your life, you're going to have to let go of the excuses. They're not serving you. They're not making you happier. Excuses just hold you down. Learn to identify when you're making excuses. They're limiting, and they're almost always BS. Instead, focus on growth and improvement. When you feel yourself saying, I don't have the time, or I'm just too tired, or in the temptation to distract yourself with idle pastimes like being on social media, checking email, if you're on Netflix, which is a huge one, and you're watching HBO Go, and you're watching a lot of TV shows, then understand that you're using this as an excuse to do what you really need to do. Remind yourself that excuses will keep you from getting there. If you don't want anything in your life to change, then just keep listening to your excuses. If you want things to improve, then you need to kick the shit out of those excuses and don't look back and move forward. Number 10, let go of thinking you are not enough. You are enough and you deserve to have everything you want. You're also your worst enemy and your hardest life critic. If you want a girl, go get her. If you see a business opportunity, go seize it. When you tell yourself you can't do it, you're always right. You can or you can't. The decision is yours. On the other hand, when you tell yourself that you are enough, that you can do anything and be anything that you want, nothing can stop you. Here's a quote from Walter D. Wintle. If you think you are beaten, you are. If you think you're outclassed, you are. Life's battles don't always go to the stronger, faster man. But soon or late, the man who wins is the one who thinks he can. I believe in this more than anything. This is it. You gotta believe in yourself. If I didn't believe that I can go out and interview these awesome guests that are on my show, they never would have happened. It's really uncommon to think that you can just go out and get the CEO of Zappos on your show. It's uncommon to watch The Wolf of Wall Street and say to yourself, hey, I'm gonna get this guy on my show. Pretty crazy to go to a conference and watch Kevin Harrington, the original Shark Tank judge, give a keynote, chase him down after 100 people are around him and he has bodyguards, and to think that somehow I can have a conversation with him and that he would be interested in my little community. Well, I did it, and he was on my show. And those are all great episodes that have helped propel this entire movement forward. I just think uncommon. I don't believe that I'm the smartest person. I don't believe that I have incredible powers or I come from a different background. In fact, my background is actually quite troubling. And I consider myself just like you who's listening, a regular guy who wants to achieve a lot in life. The difference between someone who succeeds and someone who doesn't is that the one who succeeds believes that he can. He starts taking action. He gets results. And then it builds momentum. And once you have momentum, you're just a fucking avalanche and no one can stop you. Sorry to cuss and be so blunt, but it's just that important. Don't let what others say or do affect you. Know who you are and be confident in what you bring to the table. You are enough, and nobody deserves happiness more than you. Understand the world is yours. It's not magic. It's just simply work. And you'll be met with challenges and failures, but you control your mood and the way you react to things, and you flow around them like water. You control how you react, and you control what you do next. Number 11, let go of attachment. At any second, on any day, at any moment, you could lose something or someone. Your house, your car, your phone, your relationships, they're all impermanent, and none of them can make you 100% happy. You have to understand this. Happiness comes from within. That's the whole point of this whole thing right here, this episode. And that's not a bad thing. It's the best thing ever. In fact, it means that you can be happy right now, provided you change your mindset and just let go of attachment to the unnecessary. The most satisfying experiences in life are those which are experienced without any sense of attachment. That's really it. And it can be the most liberating experience for anyone. So to understand that you don't need anything else, except for the decision to realize that you don't need anything else, and that you can be happy. You are actually born happy. You were born with everything you need to become happy. You don't need anything else. It's all within you. That's a main theme of this entire episode, and I'm going to keep beating it until it's inside your head and it never leaves. Here's a quote from Steve Marabelli. The reason many people in our society are miserable, sick, and highly stressed is because of an unhealthy attachment to things they have no control over. Easier said than done, I know, but it's not impossible, though Eastern philosophy suggests that all suffering comes from attachment. Note that this is distinct from love. Attachment comes from being afraid of losing something, but love is pure, kind, and selfless. And if you actually love it, you'll let it go. That's what actually makes love so strong, is that you love something and you are actually willing to let it go if you think it'll be better off. Where there is love, there is no room for fear. Number 12, let go of all external validations. You know yourself better than anyone else. You also know both instinctively and intellectually what's best for you. That doesn't mean there's any shortage of people in the world who would love nothing more than to tell you what to do. Don't listen to them. Don't be affected by your environment, be above it. Self-contained, someone carving out their own wild path. Make your own code of conduct and rules of honor and live by those. Here's another quote by Confucius. What the superior man seeks is in himself. What the small man seeks is in others. Okay, I have to say this one more time. What the superior man seeks is in himself. What the small man seeks is in others. So don't look to others to validate who you are and where you want to go. Just be you 100% of the time and never stop. The same goes for other pursuits. You don't need alcohol or drugs to have a good time and be accepted in a social crowd. You control your own mood. You don't have to be dependent on anything external. This applies to women as well. When you need validation from women to feel satisfied, you're coming from a position of neediness and instability and actually scarcity. You're saying you're too weak to be you without getting something from her. Therefore, you're always taking value versus giving value, which creates an environment where love cannot grow or even exist. That's dangerous, unattractive, and a recipe for disappointment, and a lifetime of disappointment at that. Be confident in who you are without needing anyone or anything else to make you feel worthwhile. If you feel you're being who you are and the girl isn't into you, who cares? Move forward. She's just basically telling you and that this saves you time so that you can go on and find the one who does care about you. You're not going to get every girl, just like not every business decision is going to work. That's life. The more you try, the more you learn, and the better you improve, and the closer you get to your goals. At the same time, you find that just being you, not needing external validation from anyone, and being confident will increase your success with women tenfold. It will eat at you from the inside out, and it will take its toll on your heart and your mental health, especially when allowed to fester and grow over time, sometimes years. Whenever you're angry, stop and put things into perspective. How significant is this, really, is what you need to ask yourself. Will you even remember this or care about this next month? How about next year? When you angrily linger on something instead of brushing it off, you magnify its effect on you, and something small turns into something big, and you look at it like it's the end of the world, but you've just blown it up, and it's all out of proportion. You give it power, and you surrender your thoughts to it. Listen, Lao Tzu said this, "The best fighter is never angry." Think about that. You would think that a fighter is someone who is always angry or has a lot of aggression to let out. But in fact, the best fighter is the best fighter because he's not allowing the external. He's being himself and he's not allowing other things to control him, which gives him complete control over his body and mind, which is what you need when you're going to go into a fight. What's more, anger tends to breed anger. Every time you really embrace your anger, you increase the likelihood that you'll get a hothead more easily in the future. It becomes your default state, your setting, and it multiplies a negative energy in your body and mind. The world has enough of that, so don't contribute to that anymore. Instead, stay cool, calm, and present, and don't let things get under your skin. You don't have time for that. You got things to accomplish and goals to achieve, and anger is set a bunch of bad winds drifting you off course in the things that truly matter in your life. All right, so we're going to take a stop here and actually cut it. So there's 21 things to let go to be happy, and I just gave you 13 of them. And I'll come back and revisit the next ones in the next episode. So stay tuned for that episode. And so far, if you're liking this content, the challenge item is for you to really think critically about the things that you're holding on to, the things that are really holding you back, and the people around you that are bringing you down. And you're going to have to take some action on which is letting them go if you truly want to be happy. So if you'd like to share any of your thoughts with me, you can just go and email andrew@knowledgeformen.com. And I'd be happy to hear from you.
Thank you for listening to the Knowledge for Men podcast show. It's been a pleasure having you be a part of a thriving community of men who want to crush it in all aspects of life. I'm on a mission here to inspire millions of guys. And with your help, we're going to make a dent in the universe. Check out knowledgeformen.com for a ton of free content that's designed to help you live a remarkable life. Again, that's knowledgeformen.com. I hope to see you there. And always remember, 2014 is the official year of the crush, where we take action to get the life we've always dreamed of. This is your host, Andrew Ferebee. And until next time, let's do it.